meeting. She's going to be coming up here.
Yeah.
When her family comes over from Australia.
Oh, I see.
They're going to whiz her. Yeah.
Yeah.
They're going to whiz her up here. I certainly won't want to impose too much of a financial stress on her in that regard. But I certainly will want to at least, as soon as I'm given time for her, when she comes up, I'll let you know.
Yeah.
So we can consolidate our meetings together.
Yeah.
Along with others to protract what we're talking about. It seems that she wants to talk only about that stuff that you got from Glass Murray.
Yeah.
Which I would say would be the common sense to do.
Yeah.
However, what she's saying, she was wanting to come and deliver it to me and leave it in my hand.
Yeah.
You know, it's like talking French to a Maori.
Yes.
You've got to sit with a Maori to teach them the language first.
Yes, yeah.
Or understand it.
Yes.
And that's going to take 24 hours.
Yeah, yes.
So that's why I'm saying her stuff is going to be, while it's still in the top category of the need, we're really just going to have to place that need as a secondary because of the amber lights that's sticking in our face at this moment.
Yeah.
Now, one is to convince bloody the Crown that we still want them to be here as a parental member of our tinoranga tiratanga, and not to remove us, to think that they got the rangatira and remove everything that was purported to be brought here, and it showed continued falsification of their bloody own government and the way they which they manipulated that. So, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
So, what I'm purporting to do is that there's a lot more in the swing of things. Determine and make sure that those things there can be done after the fact, because they're the stuff that you, the Arataki's, need to wrestle with. What I'm doing in terms of the Taumata Kaumatua, once again, is to stand in front of these bloody people and say, we are the rangatiras, we are the chief, not you. And
yeah.
We need you to listen to what we are directing you people to do. But it seems to be that with my dialogue with Kini, that enough is enough.
Mm.
We're really saying, waving them goodbye and say, get back on your boat to Britannia and sail on your way back. Pākehā is not an enemy, John. It's the Crown.
Yeah.
And we must remember that, because we've got a lot of Pākehā members of our own family.
Yeah, yeah.
And I'm not using that as an excuse. The words in the Wakaputanga, Te Tiriti Waitangi, and right up to now, we always use the word haere mai, which is the signatory of saying to them, we are one people, but it's only in one dimension, and one current. It's the way in which Pākehā have articulated a very conniving way of doing things, so that everything is now going to be resting on their law, the law that they're spelling out, which is making it hard for you to get the occupation back of that Cook Street because of the laws that they've galvanized here without their blessings. So for me, it's about talking about those orange light syndromes first, John. I can't help but think about that. I'm not saying that Sue's matter there is an urgent one. If it was, it should have been done a long time ago. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, I'm hearing.
Yeah, it should have been done a long time ago. And to wait for now, when we're going through the real rustic part of this tiriti, I'm finding it a little difficult at this moment to put room in there at the top end of the echelon. The old saying, we do need some funds, but is that the be-all and end-all thing? I'm saying no. That the mana needs to be put in place in its proper place and its proper order. That has to be number one. And so from there, all those other things will flow on, including all the things that have been conniving and that can be dealt with through a Waitangi tribunal. Those are the sort of things that can be done through that end. But in terms of what we need to do to fix ourselves up and get on with the job, there's you about the business in terms of anything to do with either agriculture or agriculture. Get on with the business thereafter. But we need to have a kickstart, and I think the money is there that Sue can expose us to, and then have the team re-elected, like what you were saying, to qualify these co-marchers to be named as the brass that will go over to UN to acquire the funds. So that's where I'm feeling at this moment, John. John.
Okay.
I did say to Sue that I'm working with alongside. I didn't mention your name, but I told your name later on, and I said that you and I have a good rapport. So she said that in regard that she was quite happy with that. There must have been some earlier, I don't know what it was, and I don't want to go there, just like I don't want to go with Kingi. And a lot of his things, because I want to say that despite all those sort of things, it has caused him to be where he is now, and the rest of Ngāpuhi, because of his ill-founded way of dealing with these political matters without having to talk to the rest of the Taumata Kaumatua before he makes statements on TV. And so I will be talking to him very shortly. If not, I'll be talking to him right now, if you want me to. And
yeah,
if you
yeah,
want
yeah,
to,
yeah. I'll be, yeah, good.
I'll talk to Kingi.
Okay, good.
So, you know, I'm a follower. I don't want to muck around.
No, don't muck around. Just do what you're doing, and I'm right there.
Okay.
I'm here behind you.
Yeah, as my secretary.
Yeah. I'm taking notes and keeping track.
I better put my glasses on. I went to the doctor's yesterday and I got pissed off and I walked out.
Oh.
Yeah, they said to me, oh, I sent you a copy of my of the letter to come up. And I said, yes. And I said, I've got my letter. And then they said, oh, you can Hohepa Epiha, da 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 da. Born da 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 da, place I yes, and said, oh, could you sign your name here? And I said, what for? I said, oh, for us to get on with the job. I said, yes, isn't that enough? I got the letter, isn't that enough? I'm here, isn't that enough? I said, what more do you want? My signature, what does that warrant me? $1 million? And then, oh no, we've got to get on with the job to deal with your iron business. I said, I've given you the affirmative yes. I don't need to sign that bloody paper. And she said, oh, we can't go on. I said, then that's it. I'll see you later. I stood up and they were amazed. Then I got up and I walked away. I'm not going to have my name attached to something that they're going to use later on
yeah.
for something else.
Aye.
So I'll talk to Kingi right now.
Okay, good.
Can you hear my phone?
Yep.
Bugger must be still asleep.
Try him again.
Kingi, you're up. I rung you 10 past 8 Thursday morning. Weather's all good. I just wanted to pick up my kōrero with you in regards to the dialogue I had with Sue Nikora. And on the other line is John Wanoa on Skype listening to the kōrero. Can you give me a ring back ASAP so that we can have further kōrero in our endeavours to put things right for when we do get to Waitangi? Again, I haven't heard from Irini Henare in regards to the call, the hui that's going to be progressed in Ngati Hine. I just wanted the time and which marae that we're going to go to. So give me a call if you can. Atewa, Hohepa, 405-1911. Yola. There you go. How precise can that be?
Yeah, well, hopefully he'll call back.
Well, he better. Because I had a witness leaving a thing on his answering machine, and that was you.
Yeah. I'm just calling him now too to see if he'll answer.
Okay.
And because he might see the phone ringing again. No, the answer phone.
No call.
Oh, what a shame.
Just answering the machine.
Yeah, can you give me a call, please? John Wanoa here.
Yeah.
Okay. Right.
So, where are you going to go to for Christmas back in Rotorua?
No, I'm going to have Christmas here with my kids.
Where?
Up at home here. They'll come and pick me up. Or usually I go to the downtown to the, the Salvation Army thing. They have a Christmas on the waterfront.
You'll get arrested when
there. Oh, shucks. I forgot about that. I can't go there. No, I'll stay with them because one is going to fly out to America and the other one flying in from America. The kids.
You get arrested going there?
Yeah, I forgot. I just forgot about that.
Now, I'll ring Bryce now.
Okay.
When the king of Hawaii is coming.
Okay. Yeah, so that was Kingi.
You give me a call, Bryce. I'm just waiting. And thank you for that email you sent me in regard to Carl Redfield's comments. I think it requires, it does require some response from the Crown. So give me a call. Just want to know what's the update of King, the King's of Hawaii's situation since we last spoke to him. All right, there's another one.
Yeah, so yep.
One out of three ain't bad.
you got the wahine, and I was just going to say with her. She's already a one-track mind to go straight out off to the UN because Hirschfeld has got all the tickets and everything pre-booked.
What are you referring to?
Sue and Hirschfeld.
Yeah,
because
she always says to me, listen to me. And I said, well, that's the very thing that I feel I've been taught to do for the last so many fucking years, to listen to people.
Listen to me. See, because...
The last thing I don't want to say this is to this one here, because she's on the right track, but her attitude is like my other nephew over here, Hemido.
She say you can't have two drivers on the bus, only one driver at a time.
I tried to say to her, this is only a telephone call. It's not a conference call.
That's I noticed that she was driving all the way.
Whether I liked it or not.
The lights are blinking all the way.
And then she said, I need to put it all.
No, she's been like that. I think I heard her saying, Mary, she wrote me off. And a bad cause.
I put a stop to those sort of negative kōrero, that we are not the enemy. We must understand, but those people, they're thinking they're so far removed from the Hohepa that they want to be personal with them. It doesn't fit to their thinking, oh, fuck you.
Yeah, so that's what happened with her, with me.
And Nuki's the same. And that's why I go on, I went on and got this decoy going, and all of a sudden the Kaumatua, which was his mate, are like Paiwinia, Bent, Maurinua, Dad, David, and them, they all jump all his stuff. We've been sitting there with them all the time, and they pretty much tell the same story.
It can't turn the dial on the radio.
They don't know how to join the boom. So you want to get away on the other side of Auckland. I said to them, here's a way. You get on the Harbour Bridge and you go a little bit.
They remind me of Holyoke, blah, 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 all the time.
Then David Longley came in and he started saying that novel language.
Yeah.
What's all you people? I'm not saying that.
Yes.
I'm coming in.
Yeah.
And then later on, Muldoon came in.
I'm going to take it all. bankrupt you all. But anyway, with Sue, she's waiting for her family from Australia to come and fund her to get around.
Yeah.
She owes me $5,000. For saying that she was going to get 30 grand from Australia. 30 million, sorry. But it seems like Hirschfeld is pushing things along with finishing the job off.
Have you ever been able to make contact with him?
No. No, I haven't. Because he wasn't in his office anymore, and I was going to get him to do my Cook Street, but he was under another practice, under another firm.
Well, he's under his own firm, isn't he?
No, not now.
Oh.
No, he got mixed up in the, legal aid stuff.
Oh, yeah. Well, he's still a barrister.
Yeah. He's still a barrister, but I've he's got all the records of the Confederation to get it through to UN and Switzerland and the World World Court.
Well, they're not. He's not the person that the UN wants. They want the elders.
Yeah, now they want the elders, but they Sue has got him because being in the family, it's kept all her legal stuff intact for what she wants to achieve to get the funding and the mandate to get the Confederation onto the seat in the UN, because it's not going to go in your head without legal stuff. And so it'll take too long to get anything going with legal stuff all over again, because there's no lawyers that can just pick all that up and go without going back through all the whakapapa, the history, because Sue's got a few years up her sleeve.
Can you still see me?
Yeah, you have just put your hat on. You just put your head on, and I can see you, I can see me in my picture. On the video is there with you.
Yeah, but I don't see you.
No, it's at your end, not mine. Because my camera's going.
Well, I don't know what I should be doing with this one here.
Because
hopefully next time you come on, something that would have happened.
Yes, because... Because all this end is working perfect because the camera is on and I can see me and you together.
Have you heard from Dee?
No, she's gone quiet.
Yeah.
Yeah, I haven't heard nothing.
I emailed to her just wishing her Merry Christmas, but I haven't heard anything from her since then.
Yeah, no, nothing. Gone quiet.
I feel sorry for that woman.
Yeah, well, I do too, because she's stuck. She really is stuck. And I said, well, I can't do much to help. And, you know, she's wishing me this luck and all that with the Cook Street. And, yeah.
Anyway, I tried to shortcut her and go straight to her mate, who was
Kim. Kim.
And wrote out the application for Matali here.
Yeah.
King even helped him in some ways, but cautioned him into some other areas. I think he ignorantly did some things, and that and his mate, her mate, rejected the application.
Yeah, that's what I got from her.
Yeah.
But it's left her stuck with nowhere to go. And I just said to her, well, if anything happens here, we'll help her. But my mate over there, Daryl Payan, is supposed to be selling one of his houses. And I told him to help her out. So it should be this week if he has any luck with selling his house.
I've got an email in the last 3 weeks. These people are talking about... and I know it's all bullshit stuff, but they wanted me to give them my email number because there's funds being left by the late somebody else named Epiha, who they can only find my name that supposedly is a relation of theirs, because the family died in a car accident. And left with $6 trillion in their account, and they didn't want the money to go to the U.S. bank. They wanted to try and find people like myself so that they can send the funds to. And I know it's a fucking scam.
Yeah, Nigeria. It sounds like what I already know.
So I just pushed delete.
Yeah, no, that's the quickest way, because it just burns our time. But
so many people can do that,
oh, they got the nerve. They'll do anything, even like window washing. You know, I wouldn't have the nerve.
And they said that I have to respond to them within 2 working weeks.
Yeah, and give your account.
Yes.
Yeah, and give it... That's game. That's being game.
Yeah, what did I miss out?
Yeah.
I gained nothing. Why should I miss out on something I haven't gained? So those sort of things that I'm now seeing that's becoming a reality. People are being greedy, of the greed that people think that money is power.
Yeah.
What you do with it.
Yes, yes.
And especially when people are getting will from belated parents or ancestors, or striking the lotto, suddenly something big come into their lives and they don't know how to manage it.
Yeah.
And that's where I find they'll go ahead and spend things. I know there's a guy who won a lotto of something like 70 million or 26 million, I think, and he spent it on cars overseas, racing cars.
Yeah.
Since long he was up in debt to his neck.
Yeah.
That was his passion.
Yeah.
Well, sometimes you find that people like that can do that and feel nothing about it.
Yeah.
Something that they've been looking forward to.
Yes, yes, yes.
Even if it was going to be 5 minutes of their life.
Yes.
It's something they were able to do.
Yes.
But coming back to us here, with Maoris whose money's been stacked away for so long, it's grown, it's got ears on, like your ears on your world.
Yeah.
They've grown that long. However, the minute they marry, still, if you know, look the way that the ages go by.
Yeah.
All they want to do is get on the piss and get
all
their problems behind them, mate.
Yeah.
And get up the next day, they're not only there, but they're stacked up.
Yes. They've got a Harley outside and no money.
I think they're there, but the army's grim.
Yeah, no, I just try Kingy again and see if he's there.
Yeah.
Hang on, wait. I'll just see if he's gonna answer.
TV sends a response.
No, he would have answered by now, because he knows my phone number. He's probably asleep. He's probably asleep. He's still up north, I think.
He must have had a hard dose on his tablet.
Well, something, because he got... Tracy sacked him out of the house. The police chased him out of the house in Auckland.
Oh,
man. Yeah, that's what she told me.
No, he never said anything to me.
No, well, you know... Oh, here he goes. Hang on. Hello? Kingy? What happened here? Went off. It rang and then it went off. Well, if you try him, he should be on the phone now.
Yeah.
Because I just... He rang back.
Oh, yeah.
I'll leave it to you to call him. Go on.